Greetings, my name is Neosekken, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Higurashi When They Cry Chapter 2. In the last episode, we found out that it appears that Rika and Satoko have gone missing. After we've essentially confessed our crimes to breaking into his storehouse to Rika and all that. So, yeah. Needless to say, the village is in Hinamizawa is in a bit of chaos right now because of all these disappearances that are occurring. And Keiichi is kind of beating himself up big time now for ever having gone into the ritual storehouse to begin with. And as for me, well, I'm still in unconvinced here that this is the work of a curse. But I still don't have any kind of clear evidence here that could point to what's really going on here, other than it seems like as though maybe some kind of conspiracy surrounding the three families is at work. And even though it's circumstantial evidence here, I still have a bit of a suspicious glance towards the Sonozaki family for maybe having a role in what's going on right now. But I still don't have any definitive proof. But all the history that I've been learning about them resulting in their power grabs after the Second World War and all that stuff, and the sheer amount of influence that they have in both the political and business spheres of both Hinamizawa and Okinomiya, there's definitely enough there here, I think, here to at least cast some suspicion on the main Sonozaki family house for what's going on here, but nothing definitive in terms of proof that they are indeed responsible for what's going on here. Which is why I do feel Ooshi's frustration that he can't really get a search warrant here to check out the main Sonozaki family's house or even the ritual storehouse. Because there may just be something in either of those places here that just might prove to contain some crucial evidence here that we can use to at least try to get an idea of as to what might actually be going on here. But unfortunately, the police's hands are tied, again because of the Sonozaki family that's putting pressure on them. And finally, it seems as though we've learned that apparently Mion seems to harbor a great amount of resentment towards Satoko for, in her view, being cursed and just bringing misfortune to other people around her as a result. And, well, I'm still kind of surprised to see that sort of thing because I've never seen anything prior to any of that that indicated that she might harbor any ill will towards Satoko. If anything, I've seen evidence to the contrary, that she's sympathetic towards Satoko's situation, to her upbringing and her life and her circumstances, frankly, because all the club members have lost people close to them as a result of all the murders and disappearances that have been occurring for the past half a decade. So that whole, frankly, insane tirade that she went into just really came out of the blue and was just kind of a surprise to me. So I still don't know what to make of it, to tell you the truth. But it's confirmed one thing to me, if nothing else, is that Mion definitely isn't all right upstairs at the moment, and I definitely need to be careful around her. Or rather, Keiichi needs to. But, I mean, I don't really see it. I don't really see how anybody can really blame Satoko for all the misfortune that's been happening around her. I mean, yeah, her parents were involved with the whole dam project and all that, and being supporters of that. But she had no control over that sort of thing, what her parents did, or even her aunt, who apparently was apparently also abusive towards her, like her parents were, which I've only just found out about last episode, courtesy of Mion's ramblings. And then there's Satoshi, who didn't seem to treat her like crap disappearing. It's just, like, I don't know. I don't really see how you can fault Satoko for any of that. If anything, she seems to me to be the biggest victim out of all this. But apparently, Mion doesn't seem to think so. Not gonna lie, I feel bad for both Satoko and even Rika, because frankly, they both had it rough. Anyway, that's enough rambling from me. Let's hit the continue. See what's awaiting us today on this undoubtedly unfortunate day that's going to happen. At least I'm predicting it's going to be another unfortunate day. I saw a ceiling I was familiar with. Though I was groggy from sleep, I did notice that I was in my futon, like I was every morning. I looked at my clock. Despite having turned in so late last night, I had awoken at precisely the same moment I always did. I'm so low on sleep. But I guess you really can get up at the same time every day. The secrets of the human body never cease to amaze me. If I went back to sleep like this, I would definitely not be waking up again. I spurred myself on and slipped out of my futon. Mom asked me about last night at breakfast. Apparently we too had gotten a call asking if we knew where Rika-chan and Satoko were, and Mom vaguely understood that something serious was happening. So then, you were out late last night with all your friends looking for them. Until about 3, I think.
Yeah.
Did you find them?
Rika-chan
and Satoko-chan, I mean. Crunch. I wearily bit into my toast. It really didn't have any taste. Just then, we heard the chime go ding-dong. I looked up the clock and saw that I was about 5 minutes past my regular meeting time with Reina. It was her at the door.
Ohayo.
Good morning.
Sukoshi wa nemureta kana?
Did you get any sleep? Did you?
何時間寝れたんだろうな?
I think I slept for a few hours.
多分、鶏の足でも数えられるくらいだと思う。
You could probably count them on a chicken's toes, though. Marina seemed pretty sleep-deprived as well. There was something missing from her usual spirit.
学校行くか?
Are you going to school?
うん。
Yeah.
その方がね、きっといいと思うの。
I think it would be better that way. She said, smiling, albeit stiffly. Reina was probably worrying her heart out about those two as well. Even so, she wanted to go to school.
今日をお休みしたら、きっとケイチ君は病んで病んで寝込んじゃうと思う。
If you stay home today, I think you'd just be worrying non-stop and sleeping.
私、そんなの嫌だから。
I don't want that.
だから、一緒に学校に行こう?
So let's go to school together. I don't know, being sleep-deprived and worrying about what happened to Rika and Satoko, I think it'd be very difficult to focus on schoolwork.
わかった。Alright.
ちょっと待っててくれ。Wait just a moment.
すぐ支度するから。
I'll get ready. I was just a little bit happy about Reina mustering that much consideration for me. We went to the place where we'd usually meet up with Mion, but she was nowhere to be found. We were a little bit late today, so we thought she'd be waiting for us.
Mii-chan, sasugani kyou wa okirarenai kamo ne.
I guess Mii-chan couldn't wake up today, huh?
Ah, sou ka.
That's right.
Aitsu ni totte wa kinou dake ja nai nda yo na.
For her, it wasn't just yesterday.
Ototoi no ban mo, sonchou-san wo sagashite tetsuya shite run da yo na.
She was up all night looking for the mayor the night before last, too. We waited for a bit. Time passed until it got to the point where it was okay for us to go on alone. And we exchanged glances.
どうする?
What do we do?
もう少し待つか?
Wait a little longer? At that point, my brain, which had finally been woken up by the morning air, recalled the ominous words Ooshi-san had left me with last night. The leaders of the three families were disappearing one after the other. And next, it might be the Sonozaki's leader. Could Mion have? No, that couldn't be.
Iko?
Let's go.
今日は寝かせておいてあげようよ。
Let's let her sleep for today. Rina gave me a pat on the back.
Mion, 本当にいるよな?
Mion, she's still here, right?
ん? 何か言ったかな?
Did you say something?
あ、いや、独り言。
Nothing, just talking to myself.
行こうぜ。
Let's get moving. Two of us head to school by ourselves. On the way, we saw a bunch of our classmates accompanied by their parents. It even looked like some of them were being taken to school by car. Surprisingly, the principal was also standing watch at the school gate. Well, considering the string of disappearances that have been occurring throughout the past few days, everybody's undoubtedly on edge, and they want to make sure everybody gets where they need to be safely. I've never seen that before.
Ohayou gozaimasu.
Good morning.
Ohayou gozaimasu.
Good morning. The principal was bowing to our classmates as guardians. The wooden sword leaning next to him was a little ominous.
Maebara-kun, ohayou.
Maebara-kun, good morning.
Ryugu-kun, ohayou.
Ryugu-kun, good morning.
ohayou gozaimasu.
Good morning.
先生から大切なお話があるから、すぐに教室に入るように。
Your teacher has something important to say, so head straight to the classroom.
いいかね?
All right. Rain and I said nothing. The madness that only existed at night had finally crawled out into the sunlight. That's what it felt like.
みなさん。おはようございます。
Good morning, everyone. The hushed conversations that have been spreading for a while now all disappeared like an illusion the moment our teacher walked in the door. Silence dominated the classroom. The principal came in for our teacher as well. This is clearly not a normal morning.
まず、校長先生から大切なお話があります。
First, the principal has something important to tell everyone.
校長先生、どうぞ。
Go ahead, Mr. Principal. The principal cleared his throat and approached the dais.
もう知っている生徒もおるだろう。
I'm sure some of you already know this. The classroom was dead silent. Everyone was staring at Rika-chan and Satoko's empty seats.The principal briefly and simply declared that Rika-chan and Satoko had gone missing. There wasn't a single person in the classroom who didn't already know. There seemed to be many, however, who couldn't accept it as the truth. It had been confirmed to them by now, by the principal's words. There were sobs throughout the classroom, and I heard a kid crying.They steadily spread throughout the whole room. The big hard principal wasn't able to keep his cool either.
Hi, 皆さん注目注目!
Okay, everyone, pay attention.
今日から当分の間、登下校は保護者の方と一緒に行います。
From today on, your parents or guardians will be taking you to school.
保護者の方の都合がつきにくい生徒は集団での登下校とします。
For those of you whose parents can't do so, you'll be coming here in groups.
プリントを作りましたので、よく読み、保護者の方にも必ず見せてください。
I made a handout, so read it carefully. Be sure to show it to your parents.
いいですね。
Understand? The teacher's voice was a little abrasive. Not even she could conceal the strain she felt from this unprecedented, abnormal situation. They should have just canceled school today. However, Reina told me that the school was also like a nursery for the students whose parents both worked, so some of them wouldn't want school to be canceled. Well then, let's begin the lesson.
委員長はお休みですね。
Class president. She's absent, I see.
では日直、号令!
Then whoever is on day duty, let me hear it.
起立!
All rise. That feeling of wanting to maintain an everyday atmosphere, even if only in school, precisely because our lives had been messed up, was something that I agreed with at this point. As for the teacher, who always had her lunch in the staff lounge, she ate in the classroom today. I had to laugh at her curry bento, which was just a rumor until now, but there was nobody to laugh with me. I really do hope that Satoko and Rika are all right. Can't help but worry about them too. Reina brought her chair and lunch over to my seat. Today, it was only the two of us. The fact that we didn't need to drag any other desks over was sad.
眠いね。
I'm sleepy.
ああ。
Yeah.
でも、もうそんなに気にならなくなったよ。
I don't feel like sleeping anymore, though.
むしろ今寝れるくらいのずぶとい神経が羨ましい。
In fact, I'm jealous of the people who could sleep at a time like this. They've got nerves of steel.
そうかもね。
You're right. I was sleepy this morning, but my drowsiness had dissipated after coming to school, constantly feeling the incredible tension. Reina's bento box didn't have its usual luster. That was to be expected. Reina was up for a long time last night, too. She wouldn't have had time to make her lunch beforehand. Since it's not like she would have gotten up early this morning.
遠慮なくつっつけよ。
Grab anything you want.
今日は素直に俺の弁当の方が立派なのを認めろ。
Go ahead. You can admit that my bento is better today.
じゃあ、遠慮なくいただくね。
Okay. Then I'll have some.
わあ、シソチーズのちくわ巻きなんて面白いな。
Wow. A chikuwa roll with perilla and cheese? That's interesting.
レナのだって、今日のはレトルトだろうけど、なかなかうまいぞ。
Reina, yours might have ready-made food in it, but it's pretty good too. I realized the two of us were desperately trying to brighten the afternoon mood to its usual level as much as we could. I looked around the classroom, and it seemed like we were the only ones trying to do so. Surrounded as we were by gloominess.
こうして二人だけでお弁当をつつき合ってると、なんだか、その、なんだかだよね、ハウ!
Just the two of us sharing our lunches like this. It's sort of, well, sort of like something. Huh? Our laughter grew quieter. I was the first one to mess up.
ごめん。
Sorry.
その、悪かった。
I mean... Well, I'm sorry.
うん、いいよ。
No, it's okay.
仕方ないよ。
It's not your fault. Our chopsticks... both stopped moving. We couldn't keep it up anymore.
Rika-chan と Satoko... どこに行ったんだろうな。
Rika-chan, Satoko. I wonder where they went. Those words might have sounded too miserable. Everyone was thinking it, using roundabout ways to address the topic. But I came right out and said it. I heard Reina catch her breath.
昨日ね、ケイチ君がいなくなってる間に、いろいろと話を聞いてたから、レナの知ってる限りを話すね。
Yesterday, while you were gone, I heard a bunch of things. So I'll tell you what I know, okay?
昨夜はすまなかった。
Sorry again about last night.
頼む。
Go ahead. At that time, since they had arrived for support, Reina was helping the ladies of society cook the miso soup we'd had. They reported all the information the villagers had gathered, and Reina said she overheard it.
でも結局何もわからなかったんだろう。
They didn't know anything important, though, did they?
学校が終わってから家に帰って、二人で自転車に乗ってどこかへ行ったらしいということ以外は、
全く。Rika-chan and Satoko went home after school, and then apparently went somewhere on their bikes, but other than that, Miona told me yesterday, we had no clues.
うん。
Yeah.
警察の人も、家に帰ってからすぐに自転車で遊びに行ったんだろうって言ってる。
The police also said that they probably went out on their bikes to go play somewhere as soon as they got home.
家に帰ってからすぐに自転車で遊びに行くところと言ったら、街かもしれないでしょ。
If they were going out to play somewhere on their bikes right after getting home, then they might have gone to town. You know, I gotta just stop here and say how, in retrospect, it's kind of ironic here that...During everything that's going on right now, it's Reina of all people that I'm counting on, that I'm viewing as the most dependable person that I have available to me right now. Whereas in Chapter 1, she was literally the last person I wanted to be around because, well, reference the later half of Chapter 1 and then, well, you'll get why if you aren't already familiar, in which case I don't see, know why you wouldn't be, but yeah, I'm justKind of ironic, in a way. You know what I mean?
だから、Okinomiya の町でいなくなったんじゃないかって結論になってるみたい。
So I guess they concluded they disappeared while in Okinomiya.
警察は明るくなってから、捜査範囲を Okinomiya にも広げるって言ってた。
I wonder why would they go to Okinomiya, though?The police were saying how they were going to expand their search to Okinomiya in the morning. In town. It makes sense why we couldn't find them even though we searched all of Hinamizawa then. Still, something didn't fit. I had no basis for thinking that. Just a gut feeling. You and me both.I revealed something to Rika-chan that was likely very important to her that day. Then, Rika-chan had told me to leave it to her. And then... what did she say? Alright. If she didn't work hard, then something bad might happen to the dog too. I think. With all the talk of dogs and cats, I still didn't have the faintest idea what she really meant, but...It might have been Rika-chan's way of saying that this was a race against time. But that still begs the question. A race against time against what, though? Damn it! I selfishly pushed my anxiety on Rika-chan and tried to run away. When I thought about it, I shouldn't have run back then. I should have asked her more. about the dogs and cats. The more I think back on it, I really screwed up. Anyway, I don't think Rika-chan was in a situation where she would just go off to play somewhere. Of course, I didn't have any evidence or conviction to base that on. It was just a hunch. I don't think she'd go into town.
Keiichi-kun mo so omou?
You think so too, Keiichi-kun?
Rena mo so omou yo.
I agree.
Rika-chan mo Satoko-chan mo Hinamizawa de inakunatta ni chigai nai no.
Rika-chan and Satoko-chan must have disappeared in Hinamizawa. I looked back at Reina, startled. I could hear the conviction in those words. Without replying to my gaze, she took her bento box and went to the hallway. I'm going to go rinse this out. Please don't disappear on me while you're at it, please. I don't want to find myself literally alone this time around. If, you know, you can help it. I timed that in a way that broke off the conversation. Sorry, she timed that in a way. Suddenly, I got the feeling that the next thing she had to say would be hard to say aloud in the classroom. I hurriedly grabbed my bento box and followed her. Reina didn't go to the kitchenette, or actually the water fountains out back, where students seldom went. The water flowed down onto our bento boxes. During that time, Reina didn't say a word. Then, after making sure there were no other students around, she finally opened her mouth to speak.
Rika-chan to Satoko-chan ga machi ni asobi ni itte inakunatta nante.
The whole thing about Rika-chan and Satoko-chan going to town to play and then disappearing.
Nandaka fu ni ochinakute. Watashi nari ni iroiro kiitari shirabetari shita no.
That didn't make sense for some reason. So I decided to investigate a little bit myself.
Kiita?
Who did you ask?
Nani wo?
What did you ask them about?
Fujinkai no obasan tachi ni iroiro.
I asked the ladies of society of all things.
Kino no miso shiru, o tofu ga ippai haiteta desho?
There was a lot of tofu in the miso soup yesterday, remember?
Tomita tofu ten no obachan mo kiteta no.
The old lady from the Tomita tofu shop came too. Tomita Tofu Shop. Oh, I remember. That was one of the stores on the road leading to the hospital. Those huge lumps of tofu dancing in the bathtub-like cistern always looked nice and refreshing.
Oba-chan, ne? Kino gakkou no kaerimichi ni Satoko-chan ga omise ni yotte o tofu o katte itta no oboeteta no.
The old lady says she remembers Satoko-chan stopping to buy tofu there on her way home from school.
Tofu?
Tofu?
学校の帰り道にだろ?
Well, it's on the way home, right?
それが何か手がかりになるのか?
How is that a clue?
いいから聞いて.
Just listen.
リカちゃんの家に行った時のこと覚えてるかな?
Do you remember when we went to Rika-chan's house? We didn't find any tofu of any kind there, did we? Now that you mention it. So it had to have happened immediately after Satoko stopped by that shop, is what you're saying. Reina stepped away from the sinks and spread her arms wide to recreate the space of Rika-chan's room. There was a pot on her gas cooker, and there was miso soup in it.
中にはお豆腐が、多分…
I think there was probably about half of it inside. The rest was in the refrigerator. They must have been planning to make chilled tofu. It was on a plate in plastic wrap. Never mind, I guess you did notice some things. As Reina explained, she walked around, as if she were really going through Rika-chan's room.
でも、Reina、それが何だって言うんだ?
Still, Reina, why does this matter?
Keiichi-kun.
Keiichi-kun.
お味噌汁のお豆腐って本当に最後の最後に入れるんだよ。
When you make miso soup, you put the tofu in last.
つまり、お料理してたリカちゃんか、もしくはサトコちゃんは、お夕飯の時間の直前まで、あそこに立って料理をしていたことになるの。
That means that Rika-chan, or Satoko-chan, whoever was cooking, was standing there making it up until right before dinner time.
夕食の時間の…
Right up until…
直前まで!
Dinner time? Wasn't everyone sane? But their bikes weren't around, so they must have gone somewhere to play by themselves? Yeah! That's definitely not matching up with what Reina has discovered.
三角コーナーのゴミを見たら、すごく不吉祥だった。
The trash in the countertop bin was put in there really awkwardly, too.
食事やお弁当はほとんどリカちゃんが作ってるんだけど、たまにね、サトコちゃんがすることもあるの。
Rika-chan makes most of their food and lunches, but occasionally Satoko-chan does it too.
だからその晩は、サトコちゃんがお料理したんだね。
So Satoko-chan was cooking that night.
それって、つまり、サトコに関しては遊びに行かず、 夕食の準備をしてたってことなのか?
So that means that Satoko at least didn't go somewhere to play. She was preparing dinner? Yeah.
それで私、炊飯釜も見てみたの。
Then I took a look at the rice cooker and…
炊飯釜には、二人分のご飯が炊けていた。
There was rice for two still in there.
ってことは、二人分の夕飯は作ったけど、二人とも夕飯は食べなかった。
So she made dinner for both of them, but neither of them ate it.
そういうことか?
Is that it? Reina nodded.
それで次に、冷蔵庫の中も見てみたの。
So next I looked in the fridge.
そうしたら、残り半分のお豆腐で作った冷ややっこがあったの。
So next I looked in the fridge. There's some chilled tofu, made from the other half that they brought,
それだけじゃない。
That's not all either.
お夕飯用に作ったおかずも何皿かあって、それらにはみんなラップがされていた。
There were a whole bunch of plates with side dishes for dinner, and all of them were in plastic wrap. You usually wrap things so you can have leftovers for the next day. My mom does it all the time too, using them in breakfast or lunch.
そう。
That's right.
ラップって、食べ残しとかを取っておくためにするものだよね。
Use plastic wrap to save leftovers for later. So why didn't they just eat the leftovers?
冷蔵庫に入れたということは、少なくともその晩のうちには食べないつもりだったということ。
So the fact that they were in the fridge means that they didn't plan on eating them that night, at least.
そういうことになるのか?
Is that what it means?
Keiichi-kun.
Keiichi-kun.
もっとよく考えて。
Think a little harder.
お夕飯を全く手つけずでラップしてあったんだよ。
Their dinner was totally untouched and wrapped up.
どういうことだと思う?
What do you think that means?
じゃあ、 夕食を食べる必要がなくなったわけだ。
That means they didn't need to eat dinner anymore.
外食とか、出前とかで。
So they would have gone out to eat or ordered takeout.
それも突然にね。
It must have been really sudden, too.
前もって決まっていたら、 お料理なんかしない。
If they had decided to do that beforehand, they wouldn't have made anything, but…
そして、お夕食は二人分用意されていた。
There was dinner for the two of them.
つまり、サトコちゃんは、二人で食事ができると、本当に直前までそう思って、料理をしていたということなの。
That means that when Satoko-chan was making their dinner, they really thought they were going to eat it until right before they didn't.
じゃあ…
So then…
二人で遊びに行っていなくなったというのは…
So then, the theory about the two of them going out to play and then disappearing is wrong!
So.
Yep.
つまり、いなくなったのはお夕飯ができて、夕食に至るまでの本当にわずかな時間。
They disappeared after making dinner and right before they ate it.
多分、7時頃くらい。
Probably around 7 o'clock.
そんな時間に、食事もせずに二人はどこへ行ったんだ?
Would they have gone at a time like that by themselves without eating?
当然そこに行き着くよね。
That's obviously where this is leading.
Keiichi-kun, 覚えてるかな?
Keiichi-kun, do you remember?
折りたたみ机が置いてあって、その上にお醤油や箸立てなんかが置いてあったの。
On their fold-out table, there were things like soy sauce and a chopstick holder. Yeah, there was. There might have been something like that. I didn't remember.
お醤油の小瓶ね。
The container for the soy sauce.
空っぽだったの。
It was empty.
もう一滴も入ってなかった。
There wasn't even a drop left.
これじゃあ冷ややっこは美味しくないよね。
Chilled tofu wouldn't taste good without it.
だから私、流しの下にある醤油の大瓶を探してみたの。
So I looked under their sink for the larger bottle of soy sauce they have.
よくそんなところにあるって知ってるな。
You sure know a lot about where they keep stuff.
私もリカちゃんの家に行ってお料理したことあったから。
I've been to Rika-chan's house and cooked for them before.Rina cleared her throat, her face returning to a serious expression.
でね、流しの下を開けてみたら、醤油の大瓶が瓶ごとなかったの。
Then when I opened the cabinet, the big bottle of soy sauce wasn't there at all.
醤油の大瓶がないと、どういう意味になるんだ?
It wasn't there. What does that mean? It means it was used at some point. After they left, probably go get themselves food somewhere.And they have some remnants of takeout in the house. So, they were present at the house after they brought home takeout. Is that what you said? What you mean?
ここから先は全部、レナの想像だからね。
Everything I'm going to say from here on is just Reina's idea.
だから最後まで、口を挟まずに聞いていてね。
So please listen until the end without saying anything. Okay.Last night, Satoko was making dinner like normal. Rika-chan usually watched TV until the food was ready, so she was probably lying down watching a variety show or something. Satoko put the tofu in the miso soup, and right when dinner was about to be ready, she noticed that they were out of soy sauce. So Rika-chan, who had nothing to do, brought the big bottle of soy sauce to a neighbor's house to borrow theirs.
俺、ご近所付き合いってよくわからないんだが、醤油なんかって分けてもらえるものなのか?
I don't really know my neighbors that well. Would people be willing to just give her soy sauce?
うん。ひなみざわではそんなに珍しいことじゃないよ。
Yeah. It's not all that uncommon in Hinamizawa. So Rika-chan rode her bike out to get some soy sauce.No matter how long Satoko-chan waited, though, Rika-chan didn't come back. So then Satoko-chan called up the house where Rika-chan was going. Would Rika happen to be imposing on you? Something like that. Then the other person must have replied with something like this.
うちに食事の用意があるから、サトコちゃんもいらっしゃい。
We have plenty of food here, so you should come too, Satoko-chan.
Rika-chan はもう食べてるよって。
Rika-chan has already eaten.
きっと、そんな感じで呼び出したんだと思う。
I think that's how they call her out there. Satoko called Rika a few names in private and wrapped up the dinner she had made for them. She put it in the fridge so she could use it for breakfast and lunch the next day.And Satoko got on her bike too, and headed her for the house where Rika-chan was.
でも、すでにこの時点でおかしいの。
So then, who do you think is the neighbors that they went, whose house they went to? Do you have any idea who that could be? Okay, but...This is already pretty strange.
食事ってね、突然やってきた人に振る舞えるほど多めに作るものじゃないんだよ。
You don't normally make so much food that you can give it to people who suddenly arrived at your house. Yeah, that definitely is strange. A veteran housewife would never normally make so much food that she could feed two extra people.
たまたま偶然作りすぎたことだって考えられるだろう。
Could have just been a coincidence that they made too much?
それでも絶対に考えられない。
It's still unthinkable. Rina flatly denied me.
だって、リカちゃんは、サトコちゃんが頑張って作ったお夕飯がもうできてることを知ってるんだよ。
Since Rika-chan knew that Satoko-chan had worked really hard to make dinner for them, didn't she?
どんなにお夕飯を勧められたって、サトコちゃんのお夕飯を無駄にするようなことをするわけがない。
No matter what kind of food she was offered, she wouldn't let Satoko-chan's dinner go to waste. It's also a good point. This is all only circumstantial evidence and Reina's guesswork. Even so, it was all extremely convincing. It was the only way of hope we had to topple the situation bereft of clues.
So, Reina...
Then, Reina...
Rika-chan was...どこへ醤油をもらいに行ったんだ?
Where did Rika-chan go? To get soy sauce. That was the heart of it. It would have to be somewhere she'd be comfortable with asking for soy sauce. And somewhere Satoko wouldn't think it suspicious that she'd been invited for dinner. Maybe a friend's house? Or a friend of a friend's house? So who was it?Rina slowly shook her head.
Rena の推理はここまで。
That's all for Rena's guesses. What if it was the Sonozaki main house? If Ooshi-san...is definitely onto something and... Well... No way, that's not his theory, it's my theory. If I'm right... And that... There might be a conspiracy going on here in the town where the Sonozaki family is the center of it all and it's making the leaders of the other three families' houses disappear...Then what better opportunity than to get rid of the Furuta family's sole surviving heir than simply taking them into your home where no one could see what's going on. And then as for Satoko, well...She'd be an inconvenient witness. If she knew that Rika would go to the Sonozaki house, had gone to the Sonozaki house, and that was the last anybody had seen of them, it would draw suspicion towards them. So, when Satoko ended up calling the house, somebody on the other line must have invited her to come on over. And then once they arrived, they'd kidnap her too.I have no hard evidence to point to any of this, but all this exposition I've been learning about the Sonozaki family, how powerful they are and what depths they're willing to go in order to achieve their goals, whether it be protecting the town of Himezawa, and even the fact here that apparently they've wasted no time gathering power for themselves after the Second World War.And aren't afraid to push their influence when it looks like it could inconvenience them in some way. It's kind of looking to me like I really need to be given the stink eye at the Sonozakis right now. Maybe we should look at the main Sonozaki house, see what's there. Maybe that's where Rika and Satoko are.
あくまでも想像だからね。
That's all for Reina's guesses. These are all just ideas, okay?
警察の人とかには内緒にしておいてね。
Keep them a secret from the police.
隠すことはないんじゃないか?
What is there to hide?
仮に半分しか会ってないとしても、きっとヒントにはなると思うぞ。
Even if only half of what you say is right, it should be a good clue for all this.
Keiichi-kun.
Keiichi-kun.
これって、Hinamizawa の人を疑うって意味だよ。
This all means suspecting someone from Hinamizawa.
確信もないのに、村の人を疑えない。
We can't suspect anyone without a really good reason. I saw a few girls coming over to rinse out their bento boxes. Reina cut the conversation short there and returned to the classroom. I stayed there alone, my body bathed in the lively voices of the cicadas. Let's think about this. In my own way. Reina had barely any information to go on, and yet she reasoned out that much. So there should be something that only I, who knew far more than Reina did, could deduce. Ooshi-san said this last night too, but this incident was definitely occurring within Hinamizawa. Reina might not want to believe it, but it's basically a given that the culprit is someone from the village. The trigger for everything was when the four of us trespassed in the forbidden storehouse. Somebody saw us going in there. For the culprits, breaking a taboo was a crime punishable by death. So that night, Tomotaki-san and Takano-san were sacrificed. Well, it's Tomotaki's death is something I'm still iffy on, because apparently he clawed out his own neck, like in Chapter 1, so... It sounds like the cause of death is exactly the same, so... I don't know how you could get someone to do that to themselves. At least not without going over the theories I had for Chapter 1 relating to his death again. There were two left. Shion and myself. However, before the culprits bore their fangs on Shion and me, they went after the mayor, to whom Shion had confessed her sin. Next, they went for Rika-chan, to whom I confessed my sin. But I should have been asking this right from the get-go, but how did the culprits know that Shion and Keiichi confessed to both the mayor and Rika? They'd have to be somebody who was either around to have witnessed such a thing, or been in a position to where they could find out about it. Like, I don't know, talking to certain people who did know, who could know what was said to the mayor or Rika. Who that could be. Next they went for Rika-chan, whom I confessed my sin. Then what about Satoko? Just a stray bullet? By itself, Rika-chan being sacrificed after I told her everything was mortifying. But Satoko, who was sacrificed for no reason, wasn't that all the more regrettable? Everything was my fault! Who would be the next to disappear? Would it be Shion and me next time? Why? Why weren't the culprits going for Shion and me right away, though? If they had enough power to erase the mayor and Rika-chan, then why not just get rid of Shion and me? If they went for us, well, I wouldn't like it, but I could still tolerate it. What I couldn't forgive was them getting rid of those we confessed to. Now that I think of it, yesterday, Shion said something alarming. She felt like someone was watching her. So then, was someone watching me as well? Strangely though, I hadn't felt like anything like that until now. Even though I'm the root cause of everything, I never once had that impression. Maybe that was simply because Shion was more cautious than me and was just careless. That's another story, though. Let's get back on track. Why weren't the culprits going after Shion and me? I feel like that's where the key to this lay. Could it be? Was I making a big assumption that I shouldn't have been? You mean that Tomotaki and Takano were killed because you four had trespassed into that storehouse? And that's basically... you're basically all being punished for a big taboo? Yeah. I definitely think that's the wrong assumption that you made right from the get-go. I thought and thought, but couldn't come up with an answer. The one thing I understood was that I was a concerned party to this case, and that I had a duty to watch over it until everything got resolved. I heard the ring of the bell declaring the end of lunch break. Would somebody else disappear tonight? If nobody else did, then I wanted them to get rid of me tonight for sure. And then put an end to all of this. Shion's hysterical voice on the phone last night came back to mind. They planned to murder those of us most close to us first. Make us as miserable as possible. And only then would they kill us.
Maebara-kun! 昼休みは終わりであるぞ。
Hey, Barakun. Lunch break is over.
教室に戻りなさい。
Go back to the classroom. At the principal's urging, I returned to the classroom, which was quiet as the streets tonight. There were a lot of parents picking up their children after school. It was just like a kindergarten. The students whose parents didn't come went home as a group. We left school with everyone else, following the assigned route. Even while leaving, nobody said anything funny. They all looked like exhausted mountaineers, silently marching through the mountains. As we went, one left, and then another. And then in the end, it was just Reina and me. I was supposed to escort Reina all the way to her house, but she declined.
本当にいいのか?
Will you be alright?
一人じゃ不用心だぞ。
It's not safe to go alone.
レナを送った後, 一人で帰るケイチ君だって同じくらい不用心だよ。
It would be just as dangerous for you to go home by yourself after bringing me back, Keiichi-kun.
まだ明るいんだもの。
It's still light out anyway.
大丈夫。
I'll be fine.
そうか。
I see.
じゃあ気をつけてな。
Then be careful, okay?
うん。
Yeah.
あれ?
Huh?
あれ、警察の人じゃないかな?
Isn't that a policeman? Hello, Ooshi. Reina pointed towards my house. There was a car stopped in front of it. From out of that car came Ooshi-san. He must have been waiting for my return to ambush me. Ooshi-san started walking over wearing that annoying grin.
レナはもう行きな。
Reina, you should go.
あいつに絡まれると長い。
If you get involved with him, you'll be here for hours.
でも、どうして警察の人がケイチ君に用があるんだろう?
What do the police want with you? With you? Reina's a good person. Even though I made a fuss over Rika-chan's disappearance, she never asked me why I did. She could have been suspecting me ever since then, and that would have been okay. Even so, she still hadn't asked me anything. She didn't try and pressure me into revealing the truth.
俺は犯人じゃない。
I'm not the culprit.
そんなの知ってるよ。
I know that.
でも、事件に何の関わりもないとは言い切れない。
I can't say that I'm totally uninvolved with this incident. Reina simply listened, smiling like she always did. Even though I had insinuated that I was related to the incident, she didn't look at me as though she were looking at something dirty.
今度話すよ。
I'll tell you next time.
うん。
Okay.
待ってるね。
I'm looking forward to it.
じゃあ、早く行きな。
Get going then. Rena gave me a slight bow and trotted away, leaving me alone with Ooshi-san, who walked over.
Domo, domo.
Hello, hello.
おかえりなさい、前原さん。
Welcome home, Maebara-san, and hello to you, you old sly fox.
どうも。
Hello.
ご家族はお留守みたいですね。
Looks like your parents aren't here.
いやはや困っていたんですよ。
My, my. Was I in a bit of a spot? Came all the way to my house. I can only thank my good fortune that my parents were absent.Since neither of them was around at this hour, they would probably be back late.
親父の仕事の関係で出かけてるんだと思います。
I think Dad got called out on business, just like with Chapter 1.
帰りは遅いと思いますよ。
I don't think he'll be back until later.
そうですか。
I see.
それはそれは好都合です。
Well, that's convenient, I suppose.
親御さんに変な思いをさせずに済みます。
We can do this without giving your parents any strange ideas. Ooshi-san pushed my back, prompting me to walk. It seemed like he wanted me to get in the car.
警察に連行するんですか?
Are you taking me to the police station? I wasn't the culprit, but I was the cause of everything. It would be weird if you wanted to investigate me.It kind of gave me a resigned feeling.
いえいえ、立ち話もなんですから、車の中でお話しようってだけですよ。
No, no. I just don't want to stand around talking. We can just talk in the car, that's all. So nobody listening in can hear us, right?
さあさあ、どうぞどうぞ。
Come now. Don't be shy. He opened the back door and urged me inside.If I got in, I wouldn't have a very easy time getting out. If I said no, however, then this man might really handcuff me and take me away. I couldn't refuse. I could only accept in good grace. The inside of the car had been cooled too much by the air conditioner, and there was a rusty smell coming from the filter, which must have been cleaned only rarely.
Ah, yeah.冷えすぎます?
Oh, is it too cold?
切りましょうか。
I'll turn the car off. He turned off the engine, and it suddenly became quiet. And the voices of Higurashi, with all their cool loneliness, snuck inside. It sounded to me like a chorus of voices, lamenting my exorbitant punishment for having harbored such foolish curiosity. For a few moments, while listening to those voices, I myself lamented the days that had been twisted and distorted since that night. Ooshi-san, as if waiting for me to voluntarily begin talking,lit a cigarette and listened to the Higurashi. The silence became deafening, and I was the only one who folded first. How's the investigation going?
捜査?
The investigation?
何のですか?
Of what?
最近はいっぱいやりすぎて、どれのことやら?
There's been so many. Which do you mean?
全部です。
All of them.
いいですよ。
Well, all right then.
本当は報道管制の敷かれた秘密捜査なんですが、あなたには特別に聞かせてあげましょう。
They're officially secret investigations, and we're under a media blackout, but I'll let you in on them.
じゃあ、最初の事件からいきます。
Shall we start from the first incident?Freak deaths of Tomotaki-san, Takino-san, night of Watanagashi.
こっちはお恥ずかしいかな。さっぱり進展なしです。
On this one, embarrassingly enough, We haven't made any progress at all.
まずは富武さん。
First of all, Tomitake said.
集団で暴行を受けた形跡はあるのですが、自分の喉をかき破るなんて異常な死に方の説明がつかないんです。
There are indications on his body that he was assaulted by a group of people. So this is exactly the same as his death from Chapter 1. Fascinating. But we have no explanation for him clawing out his own throat and dying.
何らかの薬物中毒を疑っているんですが、検出はされませんでした。
We suspect an overdose from a stimulant or something, but we didn't detect anything.
高野さんはどんな感じなんです?
What about Takano-san?
同じくさっぱりです。
The same. We're in the dark.
焼死死体は検視が非常に困難でして。
Autopsies for those who are burned to death are real tough.
首を絞められた後にガソリンをかけられたんじゃないかと見ています。
We believe she was doused in gasoline after she was strangled.
管轄がお隣の県警さんでね。
That one falls under the neighboring prefecture's police department.
あちらさん、自分たちの縄張りの事件だからって、あんまり協力的じゃないんですよ。
They haven't been very cooperative, even though it happened in our territory.
おっと、これは関係ない話ですね。
Oh, it's not really relevant, though.So the police didn't know anything other than the fact that the victims died inexplicably.
ですが、犯行時間はおおむねお祭りが終わった直後だろうと見ています。
Nonetheless, the times when the incidents occurred have been generally placed right after the festival ended.
高野さんの方はちょっとあやふやですが、富武さんとほぼ同じ時刻に殺害され、山中に遺棄されたと考えるのが妥当でしょうな。
It's a bit uncertain in Takano-san's case, but the likely prospect is that she was murdered at about the same time as Tomitake-san, then dumped in the mountains.
どうしてわざわざ遠くの山まで死体を運んだんでしょう?
Why would they bring a dead body all the way to the mountains?
Tomitake-san も同じように遠くへ運べばよかったのに。
They should have just brought Tomitake-san out there too.
ありゃ。前原さん、あなた、なかなか同期で鋭いですね。
Oh my.Mibara-san, you're quite sharp, you know that.
もちろん、私もそこは注目すべき点だと思っていますよ。
Of course, I do believe that that is something we need to be attentive of.
他にもいくつか不審点はありますが、まあ現時点でお話しできるのはこのくらいです。
There are a bunch of other suspicious things, but this is all I can tell you at this point.
村長さんの方はどうですか?
How about the mayor?
何か手がかりはありましたか?
Have there been any clues? Having exhausted that topic, I changed the subject. Otherwise, he might turn the conversation on me.
失踪された一日の足取りを調べました。
We investigated his movements on the day he disappeared.
手がかりになるようなものは見つかりませんでしたが、一応お話しましょうか。
We didn't find anything that could provide any clues, but I'll tell you about it anyway.Mayor. Keiichiru Kimiyoshi. Apparently he was suffering from severe hemorrhoids.
古い生まれの方って非常にプライドが高いんですよね。
People who lived a long time have an unusual amount of pride.
それで村長さん、誰にも内緒で獅子骨市内にある大学病院の肛門科に通われていたんです。
So the mayor hadn't been telling anyone that he was going to a proctologist at a certain university hospital in Shishibone.
失踪当日、村長さんは診察の予約が取ってあったんで、朝一で出かけられました。
On the day he disappeared, he had an appointment for a checkup, so he went out first thing in the morning. Even though I knew that big hospitals, like university hospitals, had a really long waiting time.Apparently people would get in line hours beforehand, even if they had an appointment.
診察が終わったのは午後1時頃です。
His exam ended at 1 p.m.
その後、病院内のレストランで軽食を取られ、雑誌を読みながら時間を潰されました。
After that, he ate a light meal in the hospital restaurant and passed the time reading a magazine.
この辺りのことは、自宅にあったお財布の中のレシートで分かってます。
We know this because of a receipt we found in his wallet at his house. There's nothing suspicious at all about that.
その日は夕方から神社の集会場で会合の予定があったんです。
That day, he had planned to go to a meeting in the assembly hall in the evening.
それで余裕を持ってお帰りになるはずだったんですが、途中電車で人身事故がありましてね。
He was supposed to return home with plenty of time to spare, but while he was on the train coming back, there was an accident.
どうもそれで足止めを食ってしまったらしく、家に着いたのは会合の時間の直前でした。
Seems it delayed him a bit, and he only got back to his house right before the meeting was scheduled to start.
ご家族が大慌てで神社の集会場に出かけていく村長さんを目撃しています。
His family witnessed a very hectic mayor leaving to go to the assembly hall at the shrine.
会合ってのは何だったんですか?
What was the meeting about?
確か、その会合の帰り道に失踪してるんですよね。
He disappeared on his way back home, right?
会合は御三家と町会の主要役員が集まってのものでした。
The three families and the essential members of the town assembly were at the meeting.
今年も起こってしまった連続開始事件の対応について協議したものと思われます。
We think they were discussing how to deal with the serial freak death incidents that had happened again this year. So then, on his way home, the old man who had treated Shion like his own daughter. He was a dependable person who would encourage Shion whenever she felt pressured by anxiety, and yet...Shion's painful voice struck me right in the heart.
どうなさいました?
What's the matter? I was taken aback by how strange my own voice sounded. What was it that just surprised me? I feel like I should be getting what surprised you too here, so...I guess I'm kind of slow at the moment, so could you catch me up to speed, Keiichi? What was it that just surprised me? I squeezed my head with my hands to try and drag it back out what I'd only realized for a split second. Remember, Keiichi Meibara, you just realized something. Something important. Let me look at the log.This very hectic mayor of leaving to go to assembly was mean about. They were discussing how to deal with the serial freak death incident that happened again. And on his way home, the man treated Shion like his own daughter. He's the male person who was current Shion. Okay, just spell it out for me. I feel... I'm having a slow moment at the moment. The night of Watanagashi. That was when everything started.That night, Takano-san and Tomotaki-san died. The next morning, word of the incident had spread throughout Hinamizawa. They planned to talk about it during the evening meeting. The mayor, however, had an appointment at the hospital, and as planned, he went there without telling his family. He got a checkup at the hospital.Ate something. And then there was an unexpected delay on his train right back. When he returned, the meeting was already about to start. The mayor changed clothes, got on his bicycle, and hurried to the assembly hall at the shrine as fast as he could. From when he heard about the incident on the night of Watanagashi, until he showed up at the assembly hall,Everything he was doing that day was done in secret. During that time, nobody found out that. He went to the hospital alone. He ate alone. And he got on the train alone. That meant he had absolutely no contact with anyone else. You couldn't have even called him on the phone.Okay, but what does that mean, Keiichi Meibara? Why does that matter, Keiichi Meibara?
Kei-chan. 私?
Kei-chan. What should... I do.
どうした?
What's wrong?
話せよ。
Tell me.
俺たちの間で
隠し事はなしだろ? We're not keeping serious with each
other, right? 私、君吉のおじいちゃんに
Kimiyoshi,
I
told him everything. I told him everything. I told old man Kimiyoshi everything. Oh my god. If nobody...knew where the mayor was at all throughout the entire day, then how did you, Shion, run into him? At night, I told the mayor that we snuck into the ritual storehouse. Also that someone saw us and was out to get us. Right. What then? Old man Kimiyoshi...didn't get angry. He smiled and told me it was proper and sorry about it. There was no way I'd be deeming away. Was this all a fucking lie? What you told him? He was really smiling. Told me to leave. Holy fucking shit! Sweat burst out of my body like bullets. They became one long strand and slid down, down from my forehead to my nose, and fell. So then, what does it mean? Hey, Keiichi Meibara, no more playing dumb. When did she tell him?Shion says she learned of the incident from a phone call her father had made that morning. The mayor had left the house first thing in the morning for his appointment at the hospital. He didn't tell anybody where he was going. Nobody knew about him going to the university hospital. Furthermore, his train ride back to his house was delayed by an accident. As soon as he got home, he rushed out to the assembly hall. Then the meeting at the assembly hall began.It continued until it was dark out. Then everyone left. Nobody saw him after the meeting was over. He just disappeared. Which meant... Shion lied to you about having spoken to him.
Maibara-san.
Maibara-san.
大丈夫ですか?
Are you alright?
やっぱり暑いならクーラー入れますよ。
If you're too hot, I can turn on the air conditioner, hmm? Another part of me was messing with my thoughts, demanding that I didn't think any further than that. My head was pounding violently, and the fluids packed inside it all blended together until nothing made sense. It was just about to settle, yet it had been smashed and melted in the blink of an eye.No longer able to retain its shape.
Maebara-san?
Maebara-san.
もしもし?
Maebara-san, are you in there?
Ai.
Yeah. Ooshi-san lit another cigarette. There was yet another cigarette butt placed in the ashtray. Was it displaying the passage of time? Had I? Had my thoughts frozen over for that long?
私...知ってる限りのことを話したつもりです。
I tried to tell you everything I know.
お返しに、今度は前原さんの話を聞かせてもらってもいいですよね。
Feel free to tell me anything you want, Maibara-san. Maybe you should consider telling them about Shion's little fib to you about running about talking to the mayor that day. My mind had become...a gigantic, oozing mess. My brain felt like it had been totally minced by the blades of a blender, and I couldn't think.
ほらほら、また黙り込む。
Now, don't clam up again.
もし誤解があるようなら、先に解いておきたいんですがね。
If there are any misunderstandings, I'd like to clear them up first.
私は別に、あなたが犯人だなんて思っちゃいないんです。
I don't think you're the culprit here or anything. Ooshi-san gave his best attempt at an adult smile.
あの晩、あなたたち4人が祭具殿に忍び込んだことは知っています。
I know the four of you snuck into the ritual storehouse that night.
次の日にはもう村の知る人は誰でも知る噂になってましたからね。
Everyone in the village heard rumors about the next day.
それ自体は不法侵入として問われるべきことですが、問題はそれじゃない。
That in itself means we should take you in for trespassing, but that isn't the problem.
そこで何があったかなんです。
It's what was inside.
忍び込んだ人間が次々と犠牲になるような、何があったのか。
What was inside that made the people who snuck in there end up as sacrifices?
何もなかったです。
There wasn't anything. Why are you climbing up now, goddammit? As soon as I said it, I regretted confirming my presence there. But I knew it didn't matter anymore.
本当に何もなかったんですか?
Was there really nothing in there?
だって、現にこうして中に入った人たちが次々と犠牲になってるんですよ。
I mean, everyone who went in is being sacrificed one by one, you know.
しかも、扉の鍵を付け替えた村長や、リカさんまで犠牲に。
Even the mayor and Rika-san, who switched the lock on the door, were sacrificed.
それだけの事態を引き起こす何があの中にあったんです?
What was inside that could have caused such terrible things to happen? I was far too tired of keeping quiet about this. Perhaps that was Ooshi-san's goal all along. But again, that didn't matter anymore.
大昔に使った拷問道具がたくさんしまってありました。
There were just a lot of torture devices that were used a long time ago.
それを高野さんたちと見て回りました。
I looked around at them with everyone.
本当にそれだけ?
Was that really all?
本当にそれだけです。
It was really all.
口封じをされるようなとんでもないものが隠してあったんじゃないですか?
There was nothing terrible in there that would make you keep silent.
例えば、覚醒剤の山とか。
Like a pile of psychoactive drugs.
消しの秘密工場があったとか。
Maybe a secret poppy workshop.
あるいは、ソ連か中国あたりの拳銃が山ほど積まれていたと。
Perhaps there are mountains of Soviet or Chinese handguns.
不審な木箱やコンテナが山積みされてませんでしたか?
There weren't any suspicious wooden boxes or containers packed in there. Well, there were cages for hanging up on the ceiling. There was nothing.As exaggerated as what Ooshi-san was hoping for, but I felt like, in a way, there were plenty of terrible things hidden in there. From the perspective of someone who viewed the storehouse as sacred, whether or not I thought I'd seen some crazy things didn't matter in the slightest. The four of us broke the taboo. Punish us. That should have been what happened.
あの祭具殿に何か秘密があるんじゃないかと思って捜査令状を請求したんですがね。
We put in a request for a search warrant, thinking there might have been some secrets hidden in that storehouse.
もう、空前絶後の妨害工作がありまして。
It's been the sabotage of the century.
信仰の対象に対する侮辱であり、憲法で定めた信仰の自由をなんたらかんたら。
They said it would be an insult to religious figures, and something about the right to free religion in the Constitution.
いやもう。
Jeez.
だから、実際に入ったあなたに聞くほかはなかったんですよ。
That's why I really didn't have any other recourse but to ask you, since you went in there.
本当に、古い、錆びて埃をかぶった拷問道具しかなかったです。
There really was just old, rusty, dusty torture equipment.
他に目立つものなんて、何もなかったです。
Nothing else stood out.
では、富武さんたちが殺されたのは、禁忌を破ったからという制裁だけなんですかね。
Then Tomotaki-san and Takano-san were only killed as a punishment for having broken the taboo. I didn't have an answer for the only part.
もう、いちいち隠しませんけどね。
I suppose I won't bother hiding it anymore.
あなただけが今日まで被害を免れてるんです。
You're the only one to escape harm so far. Wait, what do you mean I'm the only one? What happened to Shion?
あなた以外は全員が消えたのに、あなただけが無事なんです。
Everyone but you has disappeared and yet you alone are safe. What happened to Shion?
あなたが無事で、 あなた以外が被害に遭う。どんな違いがあったのか。
What's the difference between you and them that would protect you, but bring harm to the others?
それが知りたいんです。
That's what I want to know. There was something wrong with what Ooshi-san was saying. You alone. You alone. What?
ちょっと待ってください。
Wait. Wait a second.
あなただけがって、どういう意味ですか?
What do you mean by you alone?
ですから、あなただけが最後の生き残りなんじゃないですか?
I'm saying that you alone been left alive, right? What happened to Shion?
西宮殿に忍び込んだ小僧泥4人組の
Out of the four people who tiptoed into the storehouse for ritual implements, I mean. The only one left alive? Hold on. Shion was still...
あの晩に富武二郎さんと高野美代さんが死に、翌日、園崎紫音さんが失踪しました。
Jiro Tomitake-san and Mio Takano-san died that night, and Shion Shonzaki disappeared the next day. What?! Shion disappeared the next day? Then who the hell have I been talking to up until now?
あなただけが無事に今日までを過ごしてるんです。
Only you are still safe and sound at this point.
なぜあなただけなのか?
Why only you?
私はそれが知りたいと言ってるんです。
I'm saying that's what I want to know.
シオンが失踪したって?
Shion disappeared?
そんなバカな!
That's impossible! I unintentionally raised my voice. But I didn't care about that. Tomitake-san died. Takano-san died.And Shion disappeared? When did she disappear? What's this guy talking about?
ありゃ?とっくにご存知だったとばかり。
Oh, well now. I thought you were long since aware of this.
そんなのは初めて聞いた!
This is the first I've heard of it!
Shion が失踪した?
Shion disappeared? When?
遡ると…Watanagashi の次の日に失踪していたことになります。
Well, going back a bit, she disappeared the day after Watanagashi. Going back a bit? Stop saying stuff I don't understand!
園崎紫音さんはその日の気分で親類の家を泊まり歩いたりしますので、所在不明が当たり前なんですよ。
Shion Shonzaki spends the night at relatives' house depending on her mood on any given day.So no one thought much of not knowing where she was.
学校も気分一つでよく休みますしね。
She frequently takes days off from school, too.
先生も困り果ててました。
Her teacher has been pretty troubled by it.
そんなことは聞いてない!
I didn't ask about any of that!
Shion はいつ失踪したかって聞いてるんだ!
I'm asking you when Shion disappeared!
ですから、Watanagashi の次の日です。
I told you, it was the day after Watanagashi.If Shion disappeared, then who the fuck have I been talking to all this time? Mion? The fluids in my body all reversed direction. I lost my sense of balance. Everything I could see started to warp and twist out of shape. I simply couldn't endure it. Hang on. Shion had already disappeared. Then, that night, that call...That phone call. Who was that? Mion? She called me every night. She encouraged me. We vowed that we would do our best to live on and not be erased. Yes, that should have been a phone call of Shion. Should have been a phone call of Shion. Should have been a phone call of Shion.
学校は平気で休むし、それを自宅に知らせても取り合ってもらえないから、学校もいちいち電話しない。
She took breaks from class like it was nothing, and her family wouldn't listen when I told them, so I didn't bother calling to school in the end.
そんなこんなで、彼女が失踪したことに気づくのに、だいぶ時間がかかったんですよ。
So it ended up taking quite a while before we realized she disappeared. I felt a stabbing pain like needles were being pushed into every pore in my body. It started on my back and began spreading through the rest of me. When it completely covered the surface of my skin, it began to warm its way inside my stomach as well.
ほら、覚えてませんか?
Don't you remember?
渡流しの次の日に、私たち図書館でお会いしたでしょう?
We talked at the library after Watanagashi. So if Shion disappeared, and I've been talking to Mion all this time, then what happened? Then what the hell happened to Rika and Satoko? They disappeared just yesterday. Probably because, as Rina suspects, they ended up going to someone's house who they knew and who they trusted they could just go to get soy sauce for a recipe they were cooking last night, and then they weren't seen after that. And I suspected, without any concrete evidence of anything to support it, that it might be the Sonozaki house. So, am I onto something here? That the Sonozakis are definitely involved, and that it might actually be Mion that's doing all this shit? Did Mion kill Tomotaki? And Takano, too?
あの時、シオン様いましたよね?
Don't you remember? We talked at the library day after Watanagashi. Shion-san was there then.
あれが最後の目撃なんです。
That was the last we saw of her.
あの後、彼女の所在は確認されてないんです。
No one knows where she's been since.
そんなバカな…
That's…
そんなバカな…
I can't be… That day, Ooshi-san had only caught me, and Shion bounded away, lying that she needed to go to work. Didn't she call me that night?
エンジェルモートっていうファミレスのバイトですよね?
Yeah, and she acknowledged having just… Wait. When she called later that night, she wasn't the first to bring up how she ditched Keiichi to talk to Ooshi, wasn't she? It was Keiichi who brought it up first. And if it wasn't Shion that he was talking to, Mion could have just played along. Her job was at a restaurant called Angel Mart, right?
あの日から無断欠勤です。
She hasn't been there since that day.
今日に至るまで全てを無断欠勤しております。
She's been completely absent ever since.
お店の人も連絡を取ろうにも取れず困りきってましたよ。
The person at the restaurant couldn't get in touch with her. He was really worried.
そんなバカな…
It can't be…
そんなバカな…
It can't be…
状況証拠だけですがね。
It's only circumstantial evidence, but…
図書館でお別れしてからバイト先に向かうまで…
After she left us at the library, before she made it to work…
この間に失踪したと考えるのが妥当でしょうね。
I think it's appropriate to consider her having disappeared during that time. Right after Shion… ran away without me?
ご存知なかったみたいですね。
It seems that you didn't know.
なら、先に話せばもっと話が早かったかな?
Maybe if you had said something earlier, this would have gone more quickly.
もう、これでご理解いただけたでしょ?
Now you understand, right?
あとはあなただけなんです。
You're the only one left.
あなただけが、サイグデンに忍び込んだ4人の生き残りなんです。
You're the only survivor of the four who slipped into the ritual storehouse. It couldn't be. It just couldn't be.
次に何か起こるとすれば、それはあなたなんです。
If something else happens, it would happen to you. You're fucking right. God damn it.
前原さん、どうかご理解を。
I need you to understand that, Meibara-san. It can't be. It can't be. It can't be. Shion had already disappeared? It couldn't be. It couldn't be. I talked to her the day before yesterday. I talked to her last night. She was going to call me again today. That was Shion on the phone. Shion on the phone. It was from Shion. From Shion.
Shion-san wa tokku ni shissou shiteru ndesu.
Shion has long since disappeared.
次はあなたなんですよ。
Next will be you. Then, who was on the phone those past nights? Who was on the phone those past nights? Who was on the phone those past nights? Think, you idiot! Who else sounds exactly like her?
そんな…わかんな!
That… It can't be! Holy fucking shit. I lay down on the couch and stayed there dazed for a while. My mind was completely blank. I couldn't think about anything more than a few seconds. There was a note in my house saying that Mom and Dad would be home late and I should have some ramen or something for dinner. I could make it whenever I got hungry, but I had no appetite. So I just stared blankly at the ceiling without eating anything. The hands of the clock were already pointing at 10. Would I get another phone call like today? Even though Shion had already disappeared, would she still call me? Where were they calling from? And who were they? The more I thought about it, the more I started to tremble. I even thought about just disconnecting the phone line. If I had been thinking a little less logically, I really would have done it too. Hold on, Keiichi Meibara. Ooshi-san admitted it himself, didn't he? That Shion went missing a lot? Couldn't she have just gone to relatives that Ooshi-san didn't know about and had been there ever since? Yeah, but then why wouldn't he... I'm pretty sure he would have thought about that too, and then, well, why would he treat her like she's disappearing if he could have just found out that she was just staying at a relative's house? She's missing, man. Shion and I were both being targeted by somebody, so it wouldn't be strange to think she went somewhere she usually didn't in order to hide. That must have been why Ooshi-san couldn't locate her, and why he labeled her a disappearance. Yeah, that had to be it. Shion hadn't disappeared at all. Then, my right hand moved on its own volition and slapped me on the cheek. Its cold sting let me calm down a little.
都合よく考えすぎるなよ、前原圭一。
Don't just convince yourself of the most convenient possibility, Keiichi Meibara. I knew I didn't want to admit she had disappeared. Admitting it would mean that something terrifying was definitely happening. I just needed to figure out whether Shion was the one on the phone or not. Would I ask her if she was actually Shion? That seemed like an incredibly absurd thing to do.
でも、逃げるな、ケイジ。
What else can you do at this point, man? The way I see it, we are last on the chopping block, so if we're gonna go out anyway, we might as well at least go out figuring out what the hell this mystery is all about. Still, don't run from this, Keiichi. If the person on the other end still believed that I thought she was Shion, then it gave me a tiny advantage. Casually, completely casually, I listened to what she had to say. And fend her off. I would tear the skin off the monster. It would definitely be really scary for me. However, as the last survivor, of the people who went into the storehouse that night, this was my duty to perform. Still, then who? Who would call me and pretend to be Shion? Thank you, idiot! I may have only heard her over the phone, but her voice shouldn't be that easy to replicate. That was definitely Shion's voice. It sounded just like her. It couldn't have only been Shion. There was someone, though, wasn't there? Someone who sounded just like Shion. Mion. Who else could have done this? At this point, seriously, after all this time, all those little things that didn't quite make sense about Mion until now overwhelmed my mind. Like being questioned about sneaking into the ritual storehouse, and how she shook the ladder while spouting curses. Who else? Who else could have? Why, though? Why would Mion? Are you just feeling really fucking sore about how Keiichi has been basically stabbing you in the heart constantly since the beginning of this chapter, and are just taking out your frustration on him in the most inhumane way imaginable? Because I gotta say, if that's what this is, I guess it's a good thing then that, Keiichi won't wind up with you, huh? Not that the alternative is looking to be any better, really, but still. I thought back to the things about the Sonozaki family I had heard from Ooshi-san and Shion. Mion was always entangled in the incidents, in a position where she was omnipotent. Some of that information included things that Shion had told me after she disappeared. I madly scratched at my head. Courage. Give me the courage. Just a little bit of courage to pick up the phone. I know it will ring tonight. It'd be so easy to run away. That, though, would be the same as making it easy for them to erase me. Cannot run. I must stand up and face it. After all, the next sacrifice would definitely be me. I was sure Shion would use tricky words to try and trap me. Be careful. Be careful. I'm scared. I don't want to do this. We go. At that point, it rang. The phone rang. And I didn't know where this call was coming from. Shion had disappeared. Disappeared a long time ago. Disappeared the night after Watanagashi. Yet, until today, she had been calling me like nothing happened. Now again, tonight, the people had disappeared. Their corpses simply haven't been found. I really didn't think they were alive. So if it really was Shion on the other end, then did that mean she was calling me from another world? Of course that couldn't be. A living being calling me, pretending to be Shion. Shion was long gone. And yet, as though she were alive and well, the phone continued its incessant ringing. I didn't want to pick up if I didn't have to. I just concluded, though, that doing so wouldn't solve anything. Then, what would I do after I answered it? Would I immediately declare she wasn't Shion and ask who she was? Alternatively, would I pretend I was still fooled and try to grab her by the tail? That would probably be the safest thing to do. What I was most afraid of was what the person on the phone would do when she realized I knew she wasn't Shion. However, as long as I continued to let her think I was fooled, she wouldn't do anything extreme, right? If I just made sure to be careful, that would be the safest option. I made up my mind. I'll answer the phone. Once I do that, I'll talk to her as if nothing happened. That wasn't all I'd do this time, though. I'd scope her out. Who was she? What was she thinking? And what was she after? Why was she doing this? Was she really the one who killed Tomotaki-san and Takano-san? What happened to the mayor? What happened to Rika-chan and Satoko? I reached out for the receiver, my arm trembling. There were too many things I wanted to know. Too many things I wanted to ask. I was scared. I should start by picking up the phone. Pick it up, Keiichi. Pick it up, Keiichi!
Moshimoshi.
Hello? Oh, how relieved I would have been if it had been a call from Shion.
Kei-chan desu ka?
Kei-chan?
Watashi desu.
It's me.
Shion desu.
It's Shion. Hi, Shion. My momentary, convenient, and above all fleeting prediction was ripped into a thousand pieces. I couldn't help shaking at this point. Get ready for this. You took a long time to pick up. I thought you weren't home and was about to hang up. Sorry.
I was just
in the bath. Did your family not pick up for you?
Good.
Your parents be out right now, Kei-chan. Oh, fuck. She's gonna know that we're alone. I failed. I let her in on a fatal piece of information. That was currently the only one at my house. Well, no. They're not really... Anyway! Have you heard? About Rika-chan and Satoko? No. What happened after that? Were they found? Nah.
見つからなかった.
They weren't found.
Kei-chan, どうか気を落とさないで.
Kei-chan, please don't lose hope. If Ooshi-san hadn't let me know, then I might have allowed myself to shed a tear or two at Shion's considerate words. Instead, now that it had come to this, I couldn't take her words at face value. This person on the other end of the receiver. The more perfect a Shion they were, the more my blood curdled in fear. Sorry about that. Rika-chan and Satoko.
さらわれたんだよな?
They were kidnapped, weren't they?
はい.
Yes.
それは間違いないでしょうね.
I don't think there's much doubt. Just how cruel and grave a meaning did those words hold. Their weight astonished me. And then a moment later, I was overcome with numbness and felt like I would pass out. I had asked if Rika-chan and Satoko had been kidnapped. Shion, in turn, had answered that there wasn't much doubt. That cruel meaning behind her words.
Rika-chan to Satoko.
Rika-chan and Satoko were. No, I mean, I'm sorry.
その、村長さんはさらわれてどうなったと思う?
About the mayor. What do you think happened after he was kidnapped?
まだ生きてるんだろうか?
Do you think he's still alive? What happened to Rika-chan and Satoko after they were kidnapped? That's why I wanted to ask, but I frantically caught myself.What if she had given that question a terrifying response in such a way to sound like it had nothing to do with her? I was scared of that, so I immediately brought up the mayor. That said, however, I talked about the mayor, right? I think he was killed.
Oi, oi, so なにあっさり
Hey, hey, wait. That was quick.
人間をさらってその状態を維持するのってとても大変なことだと思います。
I think it must be really hard to kidnap someone and keep them like they are.
人質にするんでもない限り、用が済んだら殺しちゃうのが一番合理的じゃないかと。
As long as they're not hostages, it would be most practical to kill them once you were done with them. This is not good. At all.The world started to bend so much I almost lost my balance. The searing in my eyes whirled around and around like the hands of a clock and tried to swallow me whole from below. I frantically put a hand on the wall to support myself. A moment later, a severe nausea welled up within me. How was she saying such things so lightly?
殺しちゃうって、そんなにあっさり。
Kill them. So readily.
人の命を何だと思ってやがるんだ
I mean, what's all the human life or two anyway?
恐ろしいことだとは思いますが。
It's a horrible thing, but...
多分、そうではないかと。
I think that's probably what happened.If the mayor was killed, then did that mean that the same had happened? To Rika-chan and Satoko? No, that couldn't. They weren't some random old man. It was Rika-chan! It was Satoko! They couldn't. They could kill them so readily.
Rika-chan と Satoko-chan も同じだと思った方がいいでしょうね。
It's probably better to think that Rika-chan and Satoko ended up the same way. Those are the words I wanted to hear the least. And I fought them back with a scream of my own. Even though it wouldn't change anything. Still, I still couldn't help but scream.This time, the tears flowed. I've been confronted with the most horrific outcome that I've been trying to avoid considering ever since last night. And I cried. There was no longer any doubt that it was my fault. I killed them. I killed Rika-chan and Satoko. I succumb to the weakness of my own heart and confessed everything to Rika-chan. That's why they were killed. That meant I killed them. When Rika-chan looked at me with those innocent eyes, if only I hadn't given in. I... Even my voice gave out, and yet still...I cried. And cried.
Keiichi-chan.
どうか
気を確かに。
Please, just try and calm down. Impossible to ask right now, lady. Rika-chan, Satoko. They've been killed. We couldn't even find their remains. I'll never be allowed to even apologize to their faces. If that was to be my punishment, then how brutal a punishment it was. I think Shion tried to comfort me, but I didn't hear any of it. What are you going to gain by doing that? They're definitely going to target you and me next. Please, I'm asking you. Get a hold of yourself. Please. Please. Shion was shouting, imploring me with a voice that sounded like tears were in her eyes. However, I was coming to hate that the sound of that voice more and more. Don't let your temper get control of you. This is Shion killed them. I had no doubts that this person killed them. Why? 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 Why kidnap someone and then kill them? Screw curses! Are people's lives really that cheap? Erasing them and killing them without a second thought like this! You're right. You're absolutely right. It would take a demon. I felt like crushing the receiver in my hand. How long did this person plan on acting like it was someone else's problem? There was magma in the pit of my stomach. It felt like it was going to erupt at any moment. Hey, Shion. Please, tell me. Why did Hidemizawa start needing someone to die on the night of Watanagashi? That's what I'd like to know. The fighting over the dam project is over and done with! Haven't enough people been cursed already? Why is it? Why? If there's a reason, then say it! Now! I was incoherent at this point. My emotions had broken through the dam inside of me, rushing forth, and I couldn't stop them. These were not simple questions. This was an interrogation. Shion herself hadn't realized it yet. It was just too funny. It was so funny that I couldn't stop crying. I understand how you feel, Keiichi. I really do. The damn wars ended a long time ago. Yet, murders and disappearances keep happening every year under the guise of Urushiro-sama's curse. Why? Why is it happening? You tell me, bitch! Some of them had nothing to do with this, and some of them didn't deserve to be cursed. So why? Why? That's what I'm asking you! I want to know that as much as anyone! Both of our ragged breaths could be heard over the phone. Listen. Ooshiro-sama's curse never existed. It's too unrealistic. Then we heard straight from the possible corporate's mouth then. This was all the work of people! Just like you said, someone in the village is using the grand name of Urushiro-sama's curse as a justification for continuing these murders and disappearances every Watanagashi. They were cunning. They've been using a curse as a convenient tool, and every and made a system where they would get rid of two enemies in the village every year. And this year, that system killed Takano-san, Tomotaki-san. But how's that explain the death of the mayor? Or Rika? Or Satoko? And why wasn't that enough? Why did the mayor and Rika-chan and Satoko have to get killed too? I don't give a shit about the past!
Rika-chan and Satoko were not supposed to be killed.
The only thing I care about is why Rika-chan and Satoko needed to be killed. Why is that? I didn't say a word to Satoko, you know? Why even her? Why? A silence fell between us. Shion didn't answer for a while. Are you finally getting it? That I'm on to you? Keiichi-chan, please, stop being mean. A sob. Was she on crying? I don't have any idea what's going on either. Everything changed. We went to the ritual storehouse that night. It was the same for me. As I listened to Shion's bitter weeping, I could feel my agitation subsiding. When I had heard that Takano-san and Tomotaki-san had been killed that night, I doubted my ears. Then, I realized it instantly. I realized what sort of a position I was in now. The four of us snuck in there. Keiichi-chan, you and I won't be so conveniently forgiven. When I thought about that, it made my chest so tight. It was so terrifying. You know that feeling, Keiichi-chan, don't you? There was nothing fake about her words. She even understood how I felt. Don't buy into this! That's why I confessed everything to old man Kimiyoshi. You're still going on with that, huh? All of us entered the forbidden storehouse. It was just a little bit of fun. We knew we shouldn't have done it, but it really had just been for fun. It was only a bit of exploration, that was all. Takano-san, Tomotaki-san, who went in with us, were killed shortly afterward. They met such miserable ends. Since that day, I've been living in fear of when I would be attacked. There was nobody except old man Kimiyoshi who would help me. So I asked him to save me. Old man Kimiyoshi, he wasn't mad. He smiled and said, "If you're really sorry, Shion-chan, then you'd never be demoned away." I don't buy this shit anymore! He really did. Smile at me. And told me to leave it to him. Shion cried bitterly, recalling the beloved mayor's death. It was such a sad voice. that none who heard it could prevent it from twisting their hearts. It's not twisting mine, man. Did I let my emotions take over and go off at her? Don't be taken in by her! Shion was in the same situation as me. She should have been my one and only comrade. Thump. My heart pounded. My other self, deep within my mind, whispered to me. Don't forget Keiichi Meibara. Don't forget about the mayor. On the morning after Watanagashi, he was told of Takano-san and Tomotaki-san's deaths over the phone, and committed to a meeting that evening. He went to a hospital appointment. He didn't tell his family. He only made it back just in time for the meeting. He went straight to the assembly hall. That's what Ooshi-san said.
Itsu?
When?
Soncho ni uchiaketan da yo.
When did you let the mayor know? Huh?
Gomen na, Shion.
I'm sorry, Shion.
Kanashii kimochi no tokoro ni oiuchi o kakeru yo de.
It must seem like I'm kicking you while you're down, but...
Shion wa...
Shion,
打ち明けたんだよな?
Told him, right?
Kimiyoshi no ojiichan. Tsumari, soncho ni...
You told old man Kimiyoshi. The mayor?
Hi.
Yes.
Itsu... 打ち明けたんだよ?
When... did you let him know?
Eh?
Eh? I've begun to get scared of saying it aloud after hearing her sad voice. I wasn't saying it was contradictory, though. Besides, if there was a contradiction, then I want Shion to explain it to me.
村長さんは重い血を患ってて、病院にかかっていたという話は知ってるか?
Did you know that the mayor had a severe case of hemorrhoids and had gone to the hospital for treatment?
Keiichi-chan?
Keiichi-chan?
それが何か?
What does that have to?
答えてくれ。
Please, answer me.
知らないなら、知らないと答えればいい。
If you didn't know, then just say so. There was a momentary silence. Then, after stammering a few times, she replied.
血だったのは、知ってます。
I knew that he had hemorrhoids.
座る時とか、辛そうでしたから。
It looked like sitting down was really hard for him.
病院に通ってたんだ。
He was going to the hospital.
どこの病院かは知ってるよな?
You know which hospital, right?
ごめんなさい。それはちょっと知りませんけど。
I'm sorry. I don't know that much, but...
でも、ケイちゃん、それが一体何の...
Ke-chan, what does that have to do with... Shion didn't know what hospital the mayor went to. That meant it was impossible for her to have gone all the way to the hospital to confess everything. Since she didn't know his destination, then she obviously couldn't have seen him on the train either. If there were any other chance for her to contact him, it would have been after he came to Hinamizawa. The train, however, had been delayed, and he only got back right before the meeting was about to start. He didn't have time. There wouldn't have been enough time for him to listen to Shion spill the beans.
単刀直入に聞きたいんだ。
I want to ask you straight.
シオンはいつ村長に打ち明けたんだ?
Shion, when did you tell the mayor about everything?
どこで?
When
いつ?
And where?
大雑把でいいから教えてほしいんだ。
Your answer doesn't have to be precise. But please, give me one.
ケイちゃん、なんでそんなことを?
Keiichi-chan, why are you asking that? Her sob pierced into my ears. I was taken aback by the illusion that I was bullying her. Even so, I'll say it. If I'm wrong, then please correct me. Please, prove to me that you're the real Shion If she's the real Shion, though, then who was the person that they found? Then that would mean that Mion was the one that disappeared. In which case, if that's the case, then who was the Mion that I've been meeting up with at the night after the Watanagashi? This has to be Mion we're talking to.
ありえないんだよ.
It was impossible.
村長が失踪した日.
The day the mayor disappeared.
朝から消えるまで.
From dawn until he vanished.
シオンには接触できる機会は.
There was no
ありえないんだ.
There was no opportunity for you to contact him.
そんな.
That's.
村長は朝一で. 誰にも内緒の大学病院へ一人で診察に出かけた.
The mayor left first thing in the morning for his examination at the university hospital all by himself, without telling anyone.
シオンは今この病院を知らないと言った.
Shion, you just said you don't know what hospital he went to.
だから帰ってくるまで村長と接触することはできないはずだ.
So you couldn't have contacted the mayor until he got back.
そうだろう.
Isn't that right?
帰りの電車が事故で遅れたので、自宅に帰ってきたのは会合の始まる直前だった。
His train back was delayed by an accident, and he didn't return to his house until the meeting was about to start.
つまり、会合が始まるまでの時間にも打ち明ける時間的余裕はないんだ。
So there was no time for you to have told him before the meeting started either. I heard Shion repeating her weak sobs. That sort of feminine voice automatically ripped into my heart. It was so painful for me to say it.
シオンも一緒に会合に出たのか?
Shion, did you go to the meeting too?
そして会合の席上で打ち明けたのか?
Did you attend it and tell him there?
ここで打ち明けなきゃもう時間がないもんな。
If you didn't, there wouldn't have been any time left.
村長は帰宅途中で失踪するんだから。
The mayor disappeared on his way home. Shion went to the meeting, didn't she? She wouldn't have any reason to be there, though, because she wasn't among the leadership of the Shinozaki family. That would have to have been Uryu or Mion, who would be her heir. There'd be no reason for her to be there. She wouldn't be able to attend the meeting. Did she, or didn't she? The question was so simple to answer, but she didn't give me an immediate response.
実は会合にで...
Actually, with the meeting, I...
あの日、シオンが行くと言ったバイトすら君は欠勤してるんだ。
You didn't even go to the part-time job you said you went to that day.
もっと端的に言おう。
I'll say it more directly.
君は俺と一緒に行った図書館以降誰にも目撃されていない。
You haven't been since we were at the library together.
Keiichi-chan.
Keiichi-chan. Why, well...
Sonozaki Shion-wa.
Shion Sonozaki.
渡流しの翌日に失踪したんだ。
Disappeared the day after Watanagashi. The other end fell silent as a grave. Your silence is speaking volumes. It was so quiet that it was like the phone cord had been cut. I couldn't sense anyone there.
大石さんは 君がすでに失踪していると言っているんだ。
Ooshi-san says you've been missing.
でも、シオンはこうして毎晩俺に電話をかけてきてくれただろう。
Despite that, you've been calling me every night like this, haven't you? Shion's sobs were torturing me. Still, I'm pretty sure I haven't said anything wrong.
頼む, Shion.
Please, Shion.
俺が言ったことが間違ってるなら,
if something
そうだと言ってくれ。
If something I said was wrong, Please say so.
Shion! 頼むから!
Shion, I'm begging you.
Shion, お前は村長に会ってなんかないんだ。
Shion, there's no way you could have seen the mayor, but...
もし会ったとしたなら...
If you did see him...If Shion ever did have the chance to meet with the mayor on that day, then that meant...
村長が会合を終えた後...
Then you saw him after the meeting.
すなわち...
In other words...
失踪する直前、もしくは...
It could...
失踪してからしかありえないんだ!
It could have only been right after... right before he disappeared. Or else... afterward! Oh, fuck. Beep, beep, went the dial tone. I stood there dazed for a while until I realized she had hung up on me.Son of a bitch. Well, I think it's official. We are in the worst possible situation we can be in right now, and Mion is gunning for my head. Son of a bitch. She's fucking lost it. Seriously, is this all because I just... She stabbed your heart multiple times?Callously, like he did? And was the final straw just basically when he and Shion end up buying that doll that you wanted right in front of you? Was that the final straw? And then just something inside you snapped that night? Or sometime after? Either way, I mean, fucking hell. I can understand being furious at Keiichi, but holy fucking shit. Targeting literally everybody else around him. Even those who had absolutely nothing to do with what he's done. It's just... What the fuck? Let's view the tips. It's from scrapbook number 11. The problem with twins. Let me guess, that they're often very hard to distinguish from each other. This is not limited to just Hinamizawa, but in Onigafuchi Village especially. The three families detested giving birth to twins as successors. Really? The long-term dictatorship built on the precarious balance of the three families must have feared collapsing under the weight of internal strife from things like family quarrels. According to the literature, if twins were born, then they had to be culled. Yikes. Fucking yikes. With that...The very fact that both the Sonozaki family successor, Mion Sonozaki, and her twin, Shion, are alive is in itself deeply interesting. Perhaps the current leader, Uryu, is sympathetic? Of course, the twins were not cared for equally, and as their heir, Mion received special treatment. From what I've heard, despite the two of them looking exactly the same on the outside,The talent lies solely with Mion. My own observations of the two of them don't leave me with that impression. Tradition dictates that the leader of the Sonozaki family is said to inherit a demon, and that they tattoo a magnificent one onto his or her back. In accordance with tradition, there's an extremely high possibility that Mion had such a tattoo on her back. From what I've heard, there is apparently a magnificent demon tattooed on Oryu's back as well. Then, I wonder what sort of tattoo belongs to the heir, Mion. I really want to see her back. So, Mion should have a demon tattoo on her back then, huh? Interesting. I wonder how this is going to be relevant later on. And at the Suzu Mahang parlor. Reserved for the day, Suzu Mahang parlor. Clatter clack.
Andya, Kura-chan. Anta ga ichiban osoi yo. Wakai hito wa minna sorotteru.
Hey, Akura-chan. You're the last one here. All the youngsters are here already.
Jouka-san, sumimasen ne.
Excuse me, miss. Ooshi handed over a convenience store bag with a carton of cigarettes in it to the old lady who owned the Mahang parlor, and she shrewdly made herself scarce. She was used to this by now.
Oi-san, otsukaresamasu.
Ooshi-san, good work today.
Nanda, minna majime ni mattetan desu ka? Sanma demo yattereya yokatta no ni.
What, were you all earnestly waiting for me? You could have just done three-player. Everyone sitting at the Mahang tables in the small parlor were Ushi's subordinates, but there were no tiles laid out anywhere.
Minasan, denjitsu no fumin-fukyuu no sousa, hontou ni otsukaresama desu.
Everyone, I'd like to thank you for your days of investigation without sleep.
Uss!
Thank you! Energetic responses filled the parlor. Already, I'd lost the atmosphere of a place of entertainment. The situation is not looking good. The chief appears to have backed down due to Congressman Sonozaki's threats.
近日中に高野殺しはお隣の県警さんに譲り、村長たちの失踪は行方不明扱いで生活課に委ねるようです。
In the coming days, we'll hand off Takano's murder to the neighboring prefecture and give the remaining person's case of the disappearance of the mayor and the others to the community division. Damn upstart chief. The veterans in the room cursed him.
請求した令状もすべて却下されました。課長からは園崎家界隈には近づくなとまで言われています。All
of our requests for warrants were turned down as well. I've even been told by our section chief not to go anywhere near the Sonozaki house.
いやいや、困ったもんです。We're
certainly in a bind, that we are.
ちなみに、 私には来週から警視庁への研修命令が出るそうです。Great. その後は余った有給をいずれ消化しろとまで言われています。Great.
So, since we've, I think we pretty much just confirmed that Mion is, that we pretty much confirmed that Mion is the culprit, is probably the culprit behind what's been going on in this chapter. With the murders and disappearances, and is undoubtedly probably related to, is undoubtedly responsible to Rika and Satoko's disappearance as well, then Reina might be right, must be right, that they disappeared at someone at the house of someone they knew, probably a friend of theirs, and it's probably fucking Mion's house. If Rika and Satoko are both alive, then they're both probably at that house right now. And if that's the case, then we're fucking on our own, because the police can't come anywhere near the Sonozaki house, because of this pressure that they're facing from Congressman Sonozaki. Son of a fucking bitch. Incidentally, it looks like I'll be getting orders soon to go to training at the Metropolitan Police Department starting next week. After that, I've been told to take a paid vacation to Izu.
Yeah, so you no mo waruku nai desu ne.
Well, I suppose that ain't bad. He heard a few dry laughs. It wasn't anything to laugh about, but that was all they could do.
いつもそうですが、事件と車のキーの閉じ込めはよく似ています。開けるための鍵はいつもその中に閉じ込められているんです。
This always happens, but incidents are a lot like locking your keys in the car. The keys you need to unlock the door are always locked inside.
車なら修理業者を呼んで扉をこじ開ける。
For cars, you call the repairman and they'll pry open your door.
事件なら?
For incidents.
Kuma-chan, 図面を。
Kuma-chan, show the map. Kuma-guy flipped over the whiteboard. On the back was a map of the Sonozaki premises made with magnets.
私もずっとこの商売をやってます。勘には自信があるつもりですがね。今回ばかりは外れるかもしれませんよ。
Now, I've been doing this job for a long time. I've got a lot of faith in my gut, but this could be the one time it was wrong, though.
退職金が欲しい方は、私が10数える間に席を外してください。
Anyone worried about the retirement money has until the count of 10 to get out of here. Ooshi began to count to 10, and everyone counted along with him. It was their famous 10 count resolution.
9, 10.
Ah,
誰も出てかないよ。
No one's leaving.
皆さん、ご家族はもっと大切にしてくださいよ。
None of you love your families too much, is that it? Everybody laughed uproariously, cheering things up.
各自、手元の資料を確認。監視カメラの所在と資格を叩き込んでください。
I want everyone to go over their materials. Memorize the locations and blind spots of all the security cameras.
クマちゃんは指揮者で待機。
Oh, they're gonna do an unauthorized sting operation, eh? Well, maybe not a sting operation, but an unauthorized raid. Kuma-chan, you'll stand by in the command car.
非常時は私に代わって指揮をお願いしますよ。
If something happens, you'll switch with me and take over.
小宮山君は突入 A 班、淳君は突入 B 班を指揮。
Komiyama-kun will head up infiltration team A.Atsushi-kun will lead team B.
監視班は1から8まで所定の位置で監視を。
Observation teams will set up at points 1 through 8.
Bonchi-kun はタイムテーブルを厳守。
Bonchi-kun, you're responsible for keeping a strict timetable.
署に怪しまれないようローテを管理してください。
Control your rotations so HQ doesn't get wise.
さて、待機中の班が一番大仕事ですよ。課長に私の所在を聞かれたら、とぼけてください。
Now, the team on standby has the most important job, all right? If the section chief asks where I am, play dumb.
ゲストのエスコート役は私がやります。きっと会場へ連れて行きますので、皆さん気長に待っててください。
I'll handle escorting our guest. Guest? I'll probably take him to the venue, so wait patiently, everyone.
落ちるっすかね。前原圭一は
Wonderful cave. Keiichi may bar, that is.
私の見たところじゃ、明日、明後日には行けそうですよ。
From what I've seen,
コロッとね。
We're set for tomorrow or the day after in that regard. It'll be easy. Plan to escort me somewhere safe, Ooshi? You're probably not gonna get to me in time, though. Okay, so maybe we might get some unexpected assistance, depending on how things play out, from Ooshi after all. But why bring up this little thing here in the scrapbook about a tattoo on the leader's back of the Sonozaki family?I have a feeling that this is important. Okay, I'm gonna... Okay. I'm going to just toss something out, completely out of the blue. Once again, I must state I have no evidence to support this. I'm just making a baseless prediction here. But... what if the reason that I'm just now learning about this tattoo on the Sonozaki leader's back is because the person that Keiichi was talking on the phone just now, who ended up hanging up on him, doesn't have a tattoo, will somehow end up finding out that they don't have a tattoo on their back. I'm pretty sure you know what that would imply. But I'll just go ahead and just spill it out. No sense being around the bush. The way I see it, if we somehow find out that Mion that we will undoubtedly end up confronting doesn't have a tattoo on their back at all, then that will mean that Mion is actually Shion, and that she apparently did something to Mion at some point, swapped places with her, and have been basically just stringing everybody and Keiichi along for the past couple days in some sort of effort to screw with him, I guess. Why? Who the fuck knows? Otherwise, if it's Mion, then, well, I've already stated my possible theories as to why Mion would be gun for Keiichi. Not all the other people who ended up dying and disappearing, notwithstanding, of course, but just... yeah. I have a feeling that this tattoo is going to be important. I have nothing to base that on, but just a gut feeling. We're probably going to find out somehow whether or not the person that Keiichi's been talking to and dealing with all this time has a tattoo on their back or not. And once we do, then we'll know for sure how to look at all of his interactions with Mion, Shion, or whoever up until now. And then we can start panicking about what to do from there. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and just end this episode. And I guess we can figure out what the hell is going to be in store for us next time. I hope you guys enjoyed this latest episode of Higurashi When They Cry, Chapter 2. If you did and you want to see more content from me, feel free to subscribe to my channel. I'll see you all next time. Take care.